Who are you?
Hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI. I can hear you.
Cauldron Lake.
Yes, I'm at Cauldron Lake. Where are you?
How to escape. In danger. The dark presence.
Danger. Thanks. Got it. Are you okay?
No! It's my fault! It got out with my face scratched!
Sir, calm down. I'm gonna need you to take a breath.
He's changed the story. The dark presence. We must stop it before...
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've been...
Wake? Where did you come from? You've been missing for 13 years.
13.
Anderson, where did you go? All of a sudden, the radio stopped working, and then that flooding just disappeared. The crazy forest. Is this who I think it is?
Casey, say hello to Alan Wake. Mr. Wake, this is Special Agent Alex Casey. He'll escort you to our car. Casey, I'll meet you there, right after I take a look around. If the flooding's receded, there might be evidence we missed earlier.
Okay. See you there.
Alex Casey? How? Am I still... Is this the dark place? No, it can't be. I got out.
Yeah, the PI from your books has the same name as me. Great. Moving on.
Should look around. With the flooding gone, could be further clues out there. The flooding disappeared very suddenly. I wonder if there's any connection to the overlap. To Nightingale. Nightingale goes missing for 13 years, shows up murdered, and then turns into a monster. After I stop Nightingale, a rider who's also been missing for 13 years turns up. What's the connection? What kind of case is this? A creepy twig sculpture? A locked box. Is that the cult of the tree symbol on it? Notes and ammo. Looks like they're tools of the trade. The cult doesn't see their victims as people. These stashes could contain clues about the cult. Better keep an eye out for more. Nope. I need something to cut this. Warning. Activity detected. AWE. Event in progress. Cauldron Lake. What's an AWE? Casey, what exactly does the FBC do?
After New York, when I started looking for our friend here, their name came up. I pushed them for any files they had on him, but got stonewalled. They have a reputation of showing up for weird shit. They have a presence here, and now we find our writer. How about that?
Thank you.
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Hey, Mom. Before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's, just a weird case, that's all.
Well, if you need a hint, my years of board game victories tell me Colonel Mustard did it.
I'll keep an eye out for him. Love you, Dave.
Love you too, honey. Want to say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now. Is there anyone you'd like us to reach out to, Mr. Wake? You've been gone a long time.
No. No. They'd be in danger. It'll come for me.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Robert Nightingale. Do you know him? You were both here in 2010.
The Dark Presence got him back then. That's the last time I saw him. 13 years.
Tell us about the pages. You had what looks like a title page with you. Return. Is this the name of the story on these pages? The writer's name has been scratched out pretty violently, but your name can still be made out underneath.
Scratched out. Yeah. Scratch.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake?
I'm trying to remember. It's a crazy jumble, like a nightmare. It doesn't make sense. I remember.
Waking up in places with no memory of how it got there. It was out of control. I didn't need another mugshot in the fucking tabloids.
Please, give a warm welcome to to Mr. Alan Wick.
Oh! Alan! Good to see you, Alan. Great to see you. Welcome back to the show. Come on. Come on down. Sit down. Sit down. Woo! Oh, man. It is so good to see you, Alan. This must be an exciting time for you. Tell me, does it ever get old?
Sorry, does what get old?
Publishing a new book. Are you okay there, my friend? You look like you've been cooped up in the writer's room for a few too many years.
This is exactly how I feel.
You know, I've waited so long to get my hands on the sequel to Departure. You left us on quite the cliffhanger. We've all been dying to know what "it's not a lake, it's an ocean" really means.
You and me both.
Well, our wait is over. Your new book, Initiation, hits the shelves tomorrow.
What?
That's exactly what every reader will be asking. This book is mind-bending. It's so cerebral. I mean, how would you describe it? An auto-fictional thought experiment? A horror story? A postmodern detective story?
Wait. This isn't right. I haven't written anything.
He's so humble.
Okay, you got me. Good prank, very funny. But yeah, sad to say, I've not written this. I'd remember if I'd written a book, right?
Or maybe it was written by your evil double. Well played, man! That is spot on! Playing the role here! Pretending the world of the book overlaps our own? That's very meta indeed. You see, Initiation tells the story of a fictional writer named Alan Wake, who is trapped in a nightmare, desperately trying to find the manuscript of a novel he has forgotten he has written. The book is set in New York, but it might not be New York at all. He is tormented by his dark doppelganger and guided by visions of a fictional detective he has written. That's right, Alex Casey is in this book as well.
I guess we'll just keep doing this the whole show. The joke's on me.
But isn't that what you sign up for with autofiction? No, but seriously, I found the structure of the reality you build in the book fascinating. It reminded me of The Matrix. I mean, the writer is physically in his writer's room, trapped there, and he projects himself out to this dark dream of New York through the story he is writing. Like astral projection. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Go on. I should be taking notes here. This is great stuff.
Notes to that other Alan Wake in that room writing this as we speak? Are we all in your story, Alan? Wow. No, I wish you every success with your new book, Alan. I hope it's as successful as your best-selling Alex Casey series. Initiation hits the shelves tomorrow. After this, I'm sure we'll all be eagerly awaiting the culmination of this hero's journey trilogy of yours. A book called Return, perhaps. Man, thank you for one of the strangest interviews of my entire career, Alan. Always talk of meta narratives. Expecting to disappear once this scene ends.
Hello?
I'm losing it.
Something's not right here.
I needed to get home to Alice. What the hell was that interview? Some kind of joke? Initiation? I never wrote a book called Initiation.
This felt like a bad dream. Could make a good horror story. gods of Asgard. That name sounded familiar. I was a mess. I'd never heard of this talk show or Mr. Door before. None of it felt right. Was I losing my mind?
Hey! I think I've been locked in! Anybody?
Fuck. Now I have to find the code myself. Great. There was something here. A broken transmission I couldn't quite make out. What was that? A message? Oh, impossible to say. Something in the studio with me. I had to get out. I felt like a drowning man gasping for air. This place felt familiar. A ghost of a memory surfaced about riding here for countless days. A plot board for mapping out a story. On the index cards, the nightmare that just happened to me. A summary of the story so far. But other notes as well. Warnings. I'd written them. I couldn't remember what it all meant.
The name Scratch filled me with dread. I could trust these words. I had to act on them. You must write to escape. Could manifest as reality in this dark place. I'd use my writing to project myself out of this room, like a deep sea diver to go deeper and explore the depths of this prison for a way out. This room was my boat. Writing was my lifeline. I would start again at the talk show.
We have Alan Wake here, the best-selling writer of the books the films are based on. Let's do this!
Welcome back to the show. So, Alan. As the creator of the character, how do you feel about this?
Sorry, what?
I know it can be an awkward question with the man sitting right next to you, but I mean, how do you feel about him in the role of Casey? Does he look the part to you?
He looks exactly like I always imagined Casey to be. It's uncanny.
Thank you. That means so much to me. I'm a huge fan of your books.
So, problem, Alan, because on more than one occasion, you voiced your reservations about the adaptations.
It's not that. They're their own thing. They've gone with choices that are different from mine. I feel protective about my stories, and these adaptations, I don't know. I guess I just wish I could have been more involved in making them.
Well, in that case, you won't have seen this either. We have a clip from the new film, Murder Case Casey. Should we roll it, or do you want to say something first, Sam?
Nah, just roll it.
This city was an old scar that refused to heal. The rain made it fester. It needed the sun, but there was only the night. I was tired. Insomnia, plastic film. I was watching the world through a rain-slick window, my own reflection haunting the view. I was trying to track down the missing writer. My only clue was a table lamp shaped like an egg. The only thing to shed light on this sordid mystery.
Great. Murder Case Casey. Great job, Sam. Very exciting. And I'm looking forward to seeing more.
Wait, stop. What was that about a writer? About a lamp? Hello?
Ah, Lord Aid! There you are, Tom! Oh, not so much evil that not a bit of good as well. Not one without the other. Good to see you.
Hey, I can't seem to find my way out of here. Can you point me to the exit?
Not the hell of it is. Of course, Tom. The work will instruct its maker. I was gonna get something from the basement for you, but you can get it yourself now. The more cooks, the worse the soup.
Have we met before? Are you trapped in the dark place too?
You remember Ahti, the janitor. You can't be lost if you don't worry about where you are headed. So don't worry, Tom. The sun will shine even into a heap of twigs. Just remember to turn on the lights. It won't take long when you get to work.
What do you want me to get from the basement? And my name's Alan, not Tom.
Yeah, but I got a man's. A man, but a man with a tool makes two, Tom. And a man with a tool can build his own exit. It's in a shoebox. In the basement where you left it. Safe as in the Lord's purse. Here's the key.
I've been trying to find a way to escape the dark place. Any suggestions?
He who mulls about his troubles is the prisoner of his troubles. It's not easy to get out. But don't you worry, Tom. The home is still there where the heart is. I often think about it when I mop the floor and look into the puddle. Water is the memory of the world. Water finds its way.
The janitor was a bit out there, but still a friendly face. I had to trust the basement would get me out of here.
An old lamp and a shoebox. Was this what the janitor had left for me? The lamp felt significant. A tool for bringing light to the darkness. I felt a magnetic pull between the lamp and the light overhead. Whoa! When the light jumped into my lamp, the whole room changed, like something in a dream. Opening a way forward, the lamp was humming. The bulb glowed. It held the light now. I felt another surge from the lamp. I could use it again.
Thank you.
The glow in the lamp went out, shifting the light in the room. The light carved out something new from the darkness. I needed to find another way out.
Wants to drown me. I'm losing myself. I have to fight it. I have to remember the clicker, the light switch. I lost it, but I have the lamp now. The lamp the switch was cut from. This place is a nightmare. Not real, and yet more real than anything. The danger and the horror real. It feeds off my mind, twisting whatever it takes into psychotic reality. I'm trapped here. I write to escape. I've tried this many times, written countless stories, forgotten how many. I keep failing, but I must keep trying. I use the story to dive deeper. Every word I write is a step forward on this spiral of the darkness. I dive to the bottom to find the answer, the map, the key, the compass. It's combined to form a door leading out. But how do you open a door that's not a door? At the bottom of an ocean that's not an ocean, and a lake. That's not a lake.
baby.